Hello students, happy new year. This is the multiple choice questions solution from Pharmacy and Power from GATE 2013. So let us quickly check what are the questions. First question is from the Pharmacy was during the testing of the spike to type thresher for wheat crop. The throughput and the thresher capacity were found to be 750 kg per hectare and 445 kg per hectare respectively. So that input is 750 and output is 450 kg per hour. The grain to store ratio is of the crop is 1.5:1. Material other than grain, MOG collected of the main grain outlet is 0.5%. The total grain loss in percentage from all the sources will be how much percent? Okay. So let us then solve. So this is related, just have drawn thresher, spike tooth thresher. So really this is the cylinder, okay. So input is here and it comes through like the sieves and grain is taken in the outlet. So it is swinging 750 kg. 750 kg is the input. So if you see 750 kg, so it is grain to store ratio is 1.5:1. So that means if you take out of 2.5 kg, 1.5 is the grain. So out of 750, how much grain will be there? So the grain will be 750 into 1.5 divided 2.5, that is 450 kg. So that means 450 kg of grain is input in the thresher. It comes like this and it threshed, then it goes like in the sieve. It sieves or it's separated from the straw and other things. Then finally, so the grain is received at the grain outlet. The grain outlet, how much kg? 445. 445 is given. 445 kg per hour. So 450 is the input and 445 is the output. So it also it shows that 0.5% is 0.5% is not grain. So that means rest is 0.5 is not grain, so rest is grain. So that means if you say 445 into 1 minus 0.05, so that will be equal to 442.775 kg. So this is the grain received at the grain outlet and this is the input. So that means rest is the loss. So from 450 to 442.775. So that means the loss will be how much? So 450 minus 442.775. Okay. So this is the loss. So that means in kg. So if you want to find out in percentage, then it will be into 100. Okay, so that will be equal to, if you calculate, that will be 1.605%. So from this, actually, the answer comes is D. This is close, so that means this is the answer 1.61. Okay, so this is the problem about the thresher. So here actually straightforward. So next question, the rear furrow wheel in a tractor mounted disc plow is provided to generally the furrow wheel is to take the side rack. So that means the answer will be C. So to reduce the side rack. So others will not be there because reducing the frictional ballast, friction will not be there because it will be just touching the furrow wall. So there will be more friction, but so that it will not insert, so it will not reduce the frictional problems. Next is maintain the uniform depth of cut. Generally, depth of cut is taken by the either by the tractor hydraulic system, there is automatic depth and depth control, or gauge wheel. So this is a tractor mounted, so the depth of cut is taken by the automatic depth and depth control. So this is not the answer. So that means, then last one, improve the penetration of the plow. So improving the penetration of the plow, it depends on the weight of the plow in case of tailed and if it's mounted, it's depend on the tractor hydraulic system. This is automatic and depth interrupt. So this is not the answer. So this is the answer. Okay. So next question. So the cumulative discharge of a tractor mounted hydraulic spare having 7 nozzles is 2 liter per minute when the tractor is operated at 4 km per hour. If the nozzle spacing is 0.3 meter, the discharging liter per hour, liter per hectare will be how much? So first thing, let it 1 hectare is how much area, that is, you know, 10,000 square meter. Okay. So now we'll see 7 nozzles are there. 7 nozzles and the spacing is how much? 0.3. So that is 0.3 means that is equal to 7 into 0.3, that is 2.1 meter. Okay. So now the forward speed is 4 km per hour. 4 km per hour. So forward speed. So then how much time it will take to cover 10,000 meter square, that is 10,000, quickly we'll do 10,000 square meter divided by the time taken, that is 2.1 meter into speed is 4,000 meter, okay, so per second will be 3.6, so not 3.6, that is 60 per minute. Okay. So per 1000 meter it will go 60 meter 1 hour. So now if you see, this is the time taken. Okay. So just multiply, then it will be 60 will go to 60,000 divided by 2.1 into 4000. Okay, so if you can set this 3 0, this will be in 60 divided by 2.1 into 4. Okay, it's minute. So discharge will be, this is per hectare, no? So this is minute per hectare, you can see. Okay. So this is you can say this is 20 meter square per hectare. Okay. So then this minute, during this minute, how much discharge will be there? So 2 liter into 60 divided by 2.1 into 4. That is equal to how much? So 60, so another 0 is here actually, we missed, so it will be 600, okay, 600 into 2 divided to, so if you 2 cancel it out, then it will be 600 divided by 4.2, so that will be equal to 142.86 liter per. So because this was minute per hectare and this was liter per minute. So this is liter per minute, okay. Liter per minute into this one is minute per hectare. So minute cancel out. Okay. And this is liter hectare. So this is the answer. So 142.86. Next question. So a two-wheel drive tractor while negotiating a terrain indicates 100% slip of one of the rear wheels. Under such condition, the use of differential law causes fast equal speed and equal power? No, because due to the one side is there is no traction, 100% slip, there is no power is developed there. So that means this is not the answer. Then next one, equal speed and equal torque. If there is no power, so no torque, so there is no problem, not the answer. Next is equal power and equal torque distribution. So it will not be the, so this one will be on the straight path. So the answer is equal speed and unequal power. Generally the This is the answer, because speed will be same in the both wheels, but since in the traction wheel there is no power generated, so most of the power will be transferred to the other wheel, so then it will come out of the situation. Next question, a double acting hydraulic cylinder has a rod diameter equal to 1/2 of the piston diameter. If the system pressure is maintained constant, the ratio of load carrying capacity of extensions to the detections to is how much? So first quickly see, this is a double acting cylinder. Okay, so if you see, this is D, let it, this is this one is the piston diameter, so let it D, so this is 2D, it is given. So then the area will be how much of this piston side? It is AP, let it 5/4 2D square, so you need 2T, so this pi D square. What is the remaining area? This side and this side, this area, excluding this, that will be area of the piston minus this area, the piston piston rod diameter area. Then that will be 5/4 2D square minus 5/4 D square, that will be 3/5 D square. If you see, when the extension time, the pressure is same, so pressure into AP is the load. Okay, so this is extension. And retraction, that is P into rest, that is AR, let it be. So now the load, this load divided this load will be how much? So this is P into AP divided by P into AR. So that will be called PP is cancelled out. So AP by AR. So that will be equal to AP is how much? 5 D square. And AR is 3/4 pi D square, so there will be pi D square cancelled out, then it will be 4/3, which will be equal to 1.33. So the answer is given, C is the answer. So this is the load carrying capacity ratio between the extensions to. So extension stroke is this way and retraction is this way. Okay, so load will be here, little some load. Okay, so this is the problem. So next problem is, during a test, sound level was measured at 90 decibel at the operator's cabin on a tractor, taking reference sound pressure 2×10⁻⁵ newton per meter square. The measured RMS sound pressure in newton per meter square is how much? So as you know, this is very basic problem. So the formula is like this: the sound pressure level in decibel is 20 log 10 P by P0 into dB. So now you can say it is given 90 decibel. 90 is, so 20 log E you have to find out, and P is given 2×10⁻¹. Okay, so taking this side, so this 4.5 okay, anti log. It will be equal to P by 2×10⁻¹, or which imply that P will be equal to 2×10⁻⁵ into this anti-log 4.5. okay, so then you can get it is 6.32 × 10⁻¹. Okay, this is the answer. So this is for now. Goodbye.